Hi guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you are new, my name is Kerry and I love makeup and specifically eyeshadow palettes. I may have an eyeshadow palette addiction and I like to pick up a lot and review them on my channel. So if that's something you're interested in, then please do consider subscribing. I have been very naughty. It has been a long while since I have ranked my recent purchases, and I'm just keeping this to palettes alone because there are that many palettes that I can't include anything else in this, and it was super difficult to rank them, especially as we get closer to the very top. I'd just like to say, once we reach a certain point in this ranking, because I'm going to start out from the bottom and work my way to my favourite since my last video, as we get closer towards the best palettes, it's more to do with colour story and what I would reach for, because there are some corkers in this lineup. So, okay, so since the last video, I've tried to look at all the videos in between of the palettes that I've picked up and that are new. So I'm sorry if I've missed any out. Please do let me know if I have and I've missed out in the ranking. I've tried my best to not miss any out. And we're going to be starting right at the very bottom. I think I've got 20 eyeshadow palettes here. Yes, it's been that long since I've done a ranking video, apparently. So, at the very bottom, unfortunately, is going to be the I Heart Revolution Pineapple Palette. I really wanted to pick this palette up because, I mean, look at the packaging. Absolutely cute AF. And when I can get it open with these nails, the colour story looks summery and delicious and gorgeous. And I do have a video on all of these palettes, I believe. Yeah, every single one, if you just check back on my channel. I like the colour story. It's not my favourite in the world. And unfortunately, a lot of the time, Revolution brands and sister brands like I Heart Revolution are not the best quality with every single shade. It's not the most pigmented and it's not my favourite formula, especially the shimmers. Although it was pretty and I made a nice look with it, I'm not mad that I've got it. Just compared to the rest of the palettes that are coming up, it doesn't hold a candle. I need to kind of whiz through this, otherwise we're going to be here for 10 years. So the next palette I did receive in PR from W7, it's the Cool Down palette. Now there are a few reasons why this is so low. I did a video on this and I was really happy with the look and how it came out. And I was really impressed with the quality of the shadows. That's not why I'm ranking this so low. It's more because the size of the palette. I used to absolutely love gigantic, huge palettes with a passion, and the bigger the better. Now, as I'm going in my little makeup journey, the smaller and more curated the palettes, the better. And if you've been on my channel before, you will know I'm not the biggest lover of neutrals. I do have the bigger version of the W7 palette that is the more colourful tropical one, the Mardi Gras one. Absolutely love that one. That would have ranked higher than this one. This is just going to be low down because I'm going to reach for it less, because I reach for neutrals less. But it is not a bad palette. If you was wanting an affordable palette with some nice cool tone browns, this is the one. Then I have another palette that I got in PR, and this one is from Catkin Cosmetics. And again, the video I did with this, I really like the look and how it came out. But again, it is more of a muted colour story. It's not bright, it's not in your face, it's just not my personal preference. I still really enjoyed using this. I still will reach for this palette when I can get my words out. I think it is so, so pretty. I even liked the pressed glitter. Like, that was stunning. That made a massive difference in this palette because, yeah, that was really, really impactful. I do think it's pretty. It's just not one that I'll reach for over some of the others. Okay, it pains me to put this so low down, but I have an Unearthly Cosmetics palette, and it is the Leather and Lace palette. Now, I don't think I reviewed this in my last ranking video. I don't think I included it. I think it was just after that. Look, it's been a while, as we can see from the amount of palettes. When I saw this come out, I was like, oh my god, this colour story looks beautiful. It is a neutral palette for colour lovers, and that is how it was marketed, and I totally agree, and I definitely wanted it. Even the feel of the packaging, it feels luxurious and soft and nice. I really do like Unearthly Cosmetics formula in general, but I feel like, personally for me, I don't know if this is just me, I feel like the mattes in this are different. I really like the massive pan sizes. I like that we've got three rows of the three different types of colours. It's very beginner friendly in that sense. And also the packaging sends my eyes a bit funny. Is that just me? I don't know. But yeah, something to do with these mattes. Like, you can even see, it looks like it's, can you see, like, I don't know if it looks like it's getting a little bit of hard pan or something already, or what's happening here, but the mattes were not my favourite to work with. And it was really disappointing compared to the formula that I'm used to from Unearthly. Look, maybe it's just me. Maybe I'm just the odd one out, but yeah, this definitely wasn't my favourite from Unearthly. Then we have a bright, colourful palette. This one is from Made by Mitchell. What actually is this called? Where the Mangoes palette. I really like the packaging. It's stunning and gold, and it's got the mms on the front. And inside, it is a beautiful colour story. I'm not going to lie. I love bright, colourful eyeshadow, and this is bright, colourful eyeshadow. I like the amount of greens we've got in here. I am a green eyeshadow lover. I really like the fact that we've only got 3 shimmers and it is more matte heavy. But in my testing video of this, I did find the mattes on the drier side quite hardly pressed, especially this orange up here called Ripened. And although I liked the look I came out with, it just wasn't my favourite formula. I don't feel like I would reach for this over all the palettes that I've got with these types of colours, just because I found this a little bit more difficult to work with. It's just not my favourite formula, but very, very pretty colour story and nice packaging. I absolutely love to review Beauty Bay on my channel because they are affordable, usually amazing quality for eyeshadows. They just keep coming out with these gorgeous palettes. Like, they're moving on in leaps and bounds, but we have the new Mood palette that they came out with. Now, I like these ones that are a 20 colour palette just because they are more curated. I'm collecting them all. They're usually limited edition. I really like them. However, this is the first one I've looked at the packaging of and been like, I hate it. It's gross to me. I know some people really love this. I'm sorry, I mean, we can disagree, that's fine, but I really don't like the packaging and the front cover of this at all. And the colour story inside, it threw a lot of people and was like, what is this? And I was kind of in that category, although having used it, I did think it was pretty. It is the same great Beauty Bay formula that I'm used to, especially with the mattes. I don't know, I just feel like it was the colour story that let it down for me. Like, am I going to be reaching for this? It's a bit of a mishmash, if I'm honest. And when I look at it, it doesn't draw me in and make me want to use it. But I'm glad I have it. It's part of my little limited edition collection from Beauty Bay. I'm happy I've reviewed it. It's not a bad palette. If you like the Beauty Bay formula and you like this colour story, definitely recommend. And we have another Beauty Bay palette because they came out with two quite close together, it seems. We've got the Bright 2.0. Now, I do have the original Bright Matte palette, which I really, really liked. Then they brought this one out and I did a video on this one, and I was saying in the video, like, did we need this? Did we really, like, this is a gigantic palette, but this one is, it has shimmers. Now, the previous one, you could get it in the matte version, which I have, or you could have it with shimmers in the original, and apparently those shimmers were not very good. They're not the typical standard formula that we know now for Beauty Bay shimmers, but this one, the shimmers in this, it has a few different formulas of shimmers, but they are beautiful. They are really, really nice. The mattes are, they are the Beauty Bay mattes. I really, really like working with them. They are very pigmented, very blendable, but I just feel like, did we need this? After we had the other one, like, I feel like it's a little too similar to the previous one, which is why it's ranking further down. Then we have Martine Cosmetics, Martine's Diner eyeshadow palette. Look at the packaging of this. It's absolutely stunning. I really, really like it. It's the first thing I've tried from this brand, and I wasn't disappointed with the eyeshadows. I definitely want to pick up more from the brand after trying this, but the theming of this, like, look at the little diner-esque cardboard around the mirror and all of the little indentations are to do with diners. The colour story is really nice. I like how it's put together. I really like the look that I came up with. I don't know. It's sort of ranked sort of kind of in the middle-ish, and I just feel like it is on the more muted side, so maybe that's why it's coming further down, but the packaging is amazing. I was really impressed with the pigments and the shimmers. This silver is a knockout silver. But yeah, I don't really have a good reason for putting it in this spot. It just, the things that come above it, I prefer, and the things that come below it, I don't. That's kind of the point of a ranking, Kerry. Like, yeah, you have to remember these things for me, it's just personal preference, not always just about formula and things like that. It's just about my favourites in colour stories as well. Then we have a big boy. We have got the P. Louise The Money Shot palette. Now, I normally like P. Louise packaging. I hate this packaging with a passion because of these garish looking coins that are actually stuck and they don't move in my palette. It's very big and bulky. It does have a drawer with this one, which I really do like. Let me try and open it for you. Okay, so this is what she looks like. Obviously, it's full of greens, which makes me very happy. I love green eyeshadow with a passion, and I can never have enough green eyeshadow. I will continue buying it. I've probably got every shade, but still, here I am. And I really do like the P. Louise formula and quality usually. All the palettes that I've tried, I've really enjoyed. So this was a no-brainer for me picking it up, especially because I got it cheaper on the TikTok shop. Let me pull the drawer out so you can see. And this is more grunge, mustardy, deliciousness. So I feel like the colour story in this palette is lovely. Let me just adjust myself. Really, really nice, but I mean, it's huge. I don't mind having this many eyeshadows, but when it's in a packaging like this, like, how many more of these massive ones are we going to do? Because I don't know where I'm going to keep storing all of these. Like, it's getting to the point now, I'm like, can we have something a little bit more lightweight, travel friendly maybe? Then next, I'm going to rank these two in the same position. So technically, maybe not 20 palettes in the ranking order then. But we have two more P. Louise palettes. These are the Stack 'Em Up palettes, and we've got them in the green and the orange. And what are these called? Back Yourself and Health is Wealth. Is that what it's called? Yes. I really like these palettes because they are smaller. These are travel friendly, and you're still getting a gorgeous colour story with the P. Louise formula. If you like P. Louise formula, these are spectacular. I have all the other three colours as well. I have the purple, the blue, and the pink. This green one is absolutely stunning. I love it. Obviously, if you want more variety, get the bigger one. But I think, you know, if you're a green eyeshadow lover, there's nothing wrong with picking up the smaller one. And I really did like the quality of this. Same for the orange one. I don't know how much I'd reach for this one over the green one, but did I pair them together in a look? I feel like I did. I can't quite remember now. It's been a while. But again, really nice, rich tones. This is gorgeous for autumn. Nice P. Louise formula, I would recommend. Okay, from this point on, every single palette I absolutely love. I just had to place them somewhere. And it was a struggle, let me say. I'm looking at them now and I'm still thinking I could move them all around. I knew what my number one top spot was gonna be. But apart from that, from here to the number one, they could all be at the same position because they are amazing. So bear that in mind. So next up, we have got one of my favourite indie brands, Gourmand Girls Cosmetics, the Radioactive palette. This is a full palette of shimmers, duochromes, multi-chromes, absolutely spectacular, special shades. And if you haven't seen this, please check out the video on this. It's absolutely stunning. I was gifted this one in PR, but if I hadn't have been, I would have picked it up anyway, because look at it. You're not going to see all the different shifts and everything on camera. I don't know if I'm clever enough to be able to show you. Give up, Kerry. Give up a bad job, honestly. But I've never seen a red like Electro Love in this. It's sort of a pinky red. Look. I've got all the swatches and everything in the video I'm using this. I do have a code with Gourmand Girls, so please feel free to use that if you go on the site, although it is affiliated. So if you do use it, thank you so much for supporting my channel, but this is absolutely stunning. And I just feel like everything Gourmand Girls comes out with, it gets better and better and taken up to a higher level every single time. So I'm excited to see what else the brand is going to do, but then we have the Lethal Cosmetics. Is it 1UP palette? I nearly called it 7UP. No, it's not 7UP, is it? It's 1UP. It's a gaming inspired palette, which is why possibly it ranks slightly higher. I love anything gaming related. I really do like Lethal Cosmetics as a brand. Let me open. Thank you. We turn it around this way. We've got player one, player two. You have the more greeny yellowy side and the bluey pinky purpley side. I really liked this when I was playing with it. And I forgot to mention in that video that some of these shades are UV and I can't actually remember which ones are right now. And I do have a little UV torchy thing. Maybe I need to do a little Instagram post with that and do a little look and shine my little UV torch. But I really did like this. I thought the shimmers were beautiful. The mattes are really nice. They are pigmented. Lethal Cosmetics mattes aren't my absolute favourite in the world, but they are good. They are good, solid mattes. They are more on the drier side, but this palette is lovely. It's a nice little palette, especially if you like gaming. I couldn't resist the colour story. Again, I don't know if I've put these in the right order. Like, I just don't know. Like, I'm looking at them and I'm like, I like them all. So just bear that in mind. Like, ranking, yes, but these are all great palettes. Next, we've got another one that I got in PR. This is from Dream House Cosmetics, a brand new brand with their first ever launch. And I was very, very grateful to receive this palette in PR. This is the Midnight Garden palette. Look at this packaging. It is so, so pretty, and it's so exciting when a new brand is launching, UK-based indie brand. And look at this colour story. I feel like this is gorgeous for autumn. You can go so many different ways with this palette. I love the look I created. I even added gems. It was a whole thing. I think it's absolutely beautiful. I can't wait to see what the brand come out with next. But I mean, look at these greens. I just want to smear them all over my lid. I was impressed for your first ever palette that you are bringing out, a brand new brand. I think she did so, so well. Then we're going to go with the Nomad Cosmetics Fête de Provence palette. I love Nomad Cosmetics with an absolute passion. They are one of my favourite indie brands. And when this came out, I was looking at the colour story. Like, I don't have a lot like this in my collection colour story wise. I mean, I probably have every shade by now in the world. Look, stop judging me. But I love this so, so much. Destination based. Every palette that comes out, profits go to whatever the destination charity is. And I think this one was to do with bees. You've got the little bees on the packaging. And the colours in this and the colour stories, the purple next to the yellow, next to the nice warmer tones, I'm just, it's delicious. And it is on the slightly more muted side, which did draw me in a bit. I mean, you can have it bright and poppy. This shade is immense. Like, what's it called? Fleur de Mimosa. Absolutely stunning. I don't know if you'll be able to see just how gorgeous it is, but I just love this colour story. I love supporting Nomad. I think it's fantastic what they are doing. Every single palette that they bring out, I'm more and more interested in. And I've got another one coming out at the minute and I've got my eyes open. I'm looking at the clues. I'm probably going to pick it up, aren't I? Okay, next we have the Glamlight Frosted Flakes palette. I don't usually order from Glamlight because the shipping is astronomical and awful. Like, let's be honest, nobody wants to be paying that shipping if you're living in the UK. However, when this palette launched, I'm like, I've always had Frosties, Frosted Flakes in the US, with a lot of sugar on. But I love the look of this palette, the fact that it came in a cereal box, the whole sort of theming of it, and the blues and the orange, they complement each other so well. Don't necessarily blend into each other so well because on the colour wheel, but absolutely gorgeous. The shimmers in this are beautiful, shimmery, gorgeous, deliciousness, basically. You can keep it on the more neutrally side and you can go really bold and vibrant. You've got depth, you've got light shades. It's just everything that I really like. And I do like Glamlight's formula. I just wish it was cheaper to get Glamlight. Okay, then we have another Gourmand Girls palette, again from NPR. This is the Ethereal palette. This is currently the most recent palette launched by the brand, although they do have a new one coming out for Halloween. And let me tell you now, you're going to want it. But this is the Ethereal, again, another super special palette full of multi-chromes and duochromes. The video where I'm testing this out, please look at all the swatches. They are absolutely stunning. It doesn't do it justice showing you like this. Like, can I do the mirror thing again? Did I fail last time? Yes. Why am I attempting it again then? Like, Kerry, give it up as a bad job. But yeah, absolutely stunning. If I'm just doing even a neutral look and I want a special shimmer, I will dig this out. I mean, I dug this palette out on my wedding anniversary and I think it was Nova that I put all over the lid. Like, I knew this was the palette that I wanted to use that day because it is so special. And for the price of all of the shades that you get in this, I mean, duochromes and multichromes can be very, very expensive. But if you're getting a whole palette of them for the price that it comes out at, I'm sorry. I just think this is really, really good quality for the money. And again, I would have picked it up myself if I hadn't ever received it in PR. I just absolutely love Gourmand Girls. Okay, another indie brand. We can see a theme here. I really do like indie brands. This is the Odin's Eye Soulmane 2 palette. I'm probably saying that wrong and I do apologise. I really do like anything Odin's Eye brings out. They could bring out anything at this point and I would be buying it because their packaging is always goals. Their formula is impeccable. The shimmers, out of this world. What an indie brand, can I just say? And look at this colour story. I need to stop behaving like Gollum. We have depth, we have brights, we have gorgeous shimmers, we have inner corner shades. It's just so delicious. I love the style, the way that they do the pans in this sort of weird shape. I like how this is all put together. It's such a nice curated colour story. And just everything about this is... There was just no way I wasn't going to be buying this, was there? I mean, come on. If you haven't tried Odin's Eye, I would really, really recommend it. I have collected quite a lot from Odin's Eye now and I have never been disappointed with anything that I've bought from that brand, let me tell you now. It's all Norse mythology based as well. I just, the theming of everything, the quality of everything, really, really nice. Okay, we're into the top two. For those of you that have been keeping an eye on my channel and the things I've been reviewing, can you guess at this moment what the top two might be? Okay, so we have the Ace Beauté Palettopoly palette. I got the whole collection. I mean, I bought it. It was expensive, but I couldn't not. I love board games. Gaming in general, but board games I absolutely love, and I like doing palette bingo on my channel. So when there's a Palettopoly game that is playing with the palette bingo idea, of course. And also Ace Beauté, really, really nice quality eyeshadows. So I knew I was in safe hands picking up this palette, and I think this colour story is amazing. I like the size of this palette. It's not too big, but you're getting so many choices, and you can go again in so many different ways. I like that we've got in the columns, you can stick to more of a monochromatic look, but if you're actually playing the game, because the game actually does come with just the palette alone, if you are picking it up, like, it has made me put shimmers in the crease and dark shades in my inner corner, and like, it's fun, and I definitely need to play it again. Me and my friend are still planning on doing a live with both our palettes and playing the game. So do check that out. That will be coming soon. I will hopefully have information on that at some point, but I just love everything about this. The shades were really, really good quality. The shimmers are more of a little bit of a putty-like formula. I'm not mad at that. They were easy to apply. The mattes are always pigmented and blendable. Absolutely beautiful. We are into first place position, guys. And like I say, I knew this had to be number one. Here we are. It's the Nomad palette, the Montverde Cloud Forest palette. It is the most recent release from Nomad, but like I say, they have got another one in the works coming up very, very soon, and I'm super excited. The colour story. I have a 3-look video on this palette. Please do check it out if you have time and you're interested. But like I said at the very beginning of this video, I love bright, bold, vivid colours. And I love green eyeshadow. We have a lot of greens in this. We have brights. I am obsessed with this palette. This is my favourite Nomad Cosmetics palette. And that was quite a difficult choice because I did like the other Tropicaly one that they did, that the name escapes me right now. But I love this so much. I need to collect a lot more from the brand. I do have a few palettes, but I've got my eye on a lot more. It is so versatile because there's so many different colours. And again, not a huge, massive palette, but just love everything about it. The packaging, like even the outer packaging, which I am keeping of this, like even with the cutouts, the attention to detail, you get a postcard with each one because like I say, it's a destination. Yeah, this definitely had to come out as number one. It's the one that I've been reaching for, wanting to play with, thinking about. Yeah, this is up there. So I need to go and have a drink because my throat kind of hurts for talking for that amount of time. I'm sorry if this was the longest video in the absolute world. And again, I'm sorry if I missed out any palettes. I tried to remember every single one that I have picked up and reviewed since my last video like this. If this is the sort of content you enjoy, if you'd like to see numerous eyeshadow palette reviews, swatches, tutorials, that type of thing, please do consider subscribing because that is what you're going to be getting on my channel. I will have everything linked down below, my Instagram, my Patreon, and my YouTube membership. And hopefully, guys, I'll see you in the next one. Bye!